Once I know what I'm want, which order I'm going to put them in, and then I'll decide. There we go, and I'll decide if any of them want painting first, like that long. That's really large, and it might go in the middle, I think. And also, with it being silver, nickel rather than brass, antique brass like these, I think it may be nice to paint it. So I think I'll put it in the middle, like that, and I think I'll paint it as well. So just play around with the orientation, see which way around you might want to have it. I don't want them too close together, but this is quite a small block of wood, so I could just make it two hooks if I wanted to, but I think I'm going to go with three, and I think I'll paint that one as well. Now, for this project, I've got a variety of different paints, just move that out of the way, which were just lying around from various different projects that I've got. I've got some blue, some sort of like a soft beige colour, and a sort of more warm brown colour. I think what I'll do is I'll use the blue as the base colour on the wood, and then I think I'll sort of distress the edges using the dark brown colour. And then I think for the hook that I'm going to paint, I use that colour there. And then once I've painted it, I might rub it back a bit just to sort of show that there's still metal underneath and that it looks like it's been worn with age or something like that. The idea is that at the end it'll be quite shabby chic and quite sort of vintage looking, quite old. So, okay, I'll just set up and get going. Okay. Okay, I don't think you need to see me paint at real time, so let's fast forward this next bit. Okay, that's the first coat of that. I'll just let that dry. I don't know whether it will need another coat, especially since I'm going to be distressing it, so see how it is once it's dry, and that's that. Okay, now stage two. I'm going to paint this lovely silver hook. I'm not sure how I'm going to be able to get this to dry because it falls forward, but oh, it's not doing it there, so depending on where I put it, perhaps it, or how carefully I put it down. Okay, first of all, I'll paint this top bit here. This is the beige colour, and as I say, I'm going to sand this back. I suppose if it falls over when it dries, it doesn't matter too much. I'm going to sand it back. I'm not worried about how neat a job I do of this paint either, because again, it's going to get sanded back. So I'm just using the same colour on the brush, the same brushes I just used for the blue. It doesn't matter if it's got a bit of blue in it, because the colours are, you know, they're totally different, but for some reason you can't tell one from the other on the brush. So it is breaking up a little bit when it's drying, this one. It'll be because it's painted onto metal rather than onto a sort of porous surface or anything, so we'll see how this one works, and if it dries, it should dry. It might break apart as it dries, and that might mean as well that it cracks when I sand it. It might just flake off. Anyway, we'll have a go. I've got other things I can do if that happens. I've got a spray paint that I can use that matches the colouring, so if necessary, I'll just put some of that paint on instead, which is this one here. As you can see, the dark colour there is a very close colour to this colour that I'm going to use for the distressing, so that colour will definitely spray onto the metal if this colour doesn't dry or doesn't stay on when I sand it. We'll see. That's the point of crafting. Sometimes you have to experiment. Okay. I'll just fast forward through this. I just wanted to show you quickly what I meant when I said that it's breaking up a bit here. You can't really see very clearly, it's not really focusing. See if I can get it to focus. No. Okay. I think you can sort of make out that it's not a very clear coat. It was put on, clearly, and it's sort of breaking up. You just can't really focus on that, unfortunately. Sorry, this camera's got an autofocus and it doesn't seem to be liking being this close. Anyway, as I say, it's probably because the paint's water-based and it's going over a metal surface. We'll see how it is when it dries and whether it needs to be, whether it works when it sands back or not. And if not, I'll just spray paint it and then that'll be fine. Okay, let's see what happens later. And that's nearly dry already. Okay, let's see what happens soon. Right, bye. Hi, okay, so we've got the plaque dry now and the hook is nearly dry. I've just tried to sand a bit back here. This area here was dry, and I quite like the way it breaks in places and not in others, and it kind of scuffs the metal back a little bit. So I think I'm going to go with that. Provided this works all over, then that's the effect I'm going for. So that's quite nice. I'm going to wait for the paint to fully dry on that first. So I'll just set that aside, and then. What I'm working on now is the plaque. I've lifted that up because it did stick to the paper a bit. So, right, okay. So what I'm going to use, as you know, is the is this paint here, the darker brown colour. And it comes with like a sponge applicator. I'm not bothered about using that particularly because I find it tends to leave more paint than you actually want. I've used this already, more paint than you actually want to put on the thing. So go back to my trusty paintbrush. I'm just going to squeeze a bit out onto here and then work with that. So you can see the sort of colour that it is. It's just a sort of almost a grey brown, soft sort of colour. It's a nice colour. I've used it in a couple of places, so go with that, and we'll just get a dry brush of it, get some on the brush, and then kind of almost get rid of it, and then just literally brush it across the surface here, as you can see, and it just leaves a little bit of a residue here. Anyway, I'm going to do this two-handed, so I'll just set this off for you to watch me carry on. Okay, so you can see that's now thoroughly shabbied, definitely shabby, not yet chic, but just mostly shabby. So at the moment you can see I've paid quite sort of close attention to the corners, getting plenty on these little edges where the detail is, really where it would get some signs of wear if it was in use for a long time, some areas more so than others, and then on the front, you know, it can be quite patchy with it, areas where It might look a bit like wood that's getting a bit of a line running along it where it might be starting to fall apart. I mean, really, if you wanted to before you started this, you could even hack into the wood a little bit, you know, get some sandpaper, some really strong grit sandpaper, get a chisel, anything, make some really kind of really rough dents into this, bash away at it and make it look really old, and then you could actually pick out those details with this darker color. That would look really nice too. And literally, you know, go over it. If there's any areas that you want that maybe look too even, you can go over them, really scrub that paint in there, and it looks really good no matter, you know, how far you take it. It doesn't seem to look like you've gone too far. Another thing I might do afterwards is go over it on the very corners, perhaps with a bit of sandpaper, and just literally take off some of this paint on the corners so that it looks even older still. And that's that basically. Hi there. Okay, so we now have the next stage of the game. As I said before, we've sanded the edges here now, so this is all ready now just to be varnished. So I've got my varnish here, which is just a clear matte varnish, and it does a very good job of staying matte as well. Sometimes varnishes that say they're matte actually have a slight sheen. That's not what I want. So I shall just now varnish that up. Next thing will be to put the hooks on. Right. Okay, so now I'm just going to let that dry. One thing I will mention when you work with this type of varnish, because it's a water-based varnish, you do have to work quite quickly and try not to brush over the same area too much, because with these water-based emulsions, you could eventually start to lift the colour that you're actually trying to varnish over. If you scrub too much with the paintbrush, it will start to lift the paint off. So try and keep as few strokes as possible just to cover it. You can always, on a second coat, if you want to make a nice smooth coat, you can sand it back and then put another coat on. Once you've sealed the surface, it's much easier to do that. But the first coat should always be done as quickly and, you know, relatively smoothly as possible, but not to scrub too much on it. Okay, next thing will be to fix these hooks on. Okay, bye. Okay, so I'm back in the studio now, and I just wanted to basically show you where I'm up to now with the hooks, and the next stage is to put it up on the wall, which is going to go just here. It's just a hook for some of the items that I use in here. It's not necessarily for coats. I've actually got a coat hook next to the door for that. So it's just going to go on here in this area here. It's just this is just chipboard, so I can just screw straight into it. I don't have to pre-drill through brick or anything complicated like that. So the actual piece that I've got at the moment, I've marked out where the screw holes would need to be, and I'm literally just going to screw it into the wall. I will pre-drill these holes first just to give them a start, because the wood's actually quite hard. So I'm going to pre-drill those now, and then I shall put them onto the wall. That's it, up, and looks good. I'm pleased with that. So I hope you like that, and you get some useful information from it. Everything's going to be different. You know, anyone else does something like this, it's going to have its own ideas, its own difficulties, but I hope that some of the things that I've come across will help you with yours. Anyway, so thanks very much for tuning in. Bye.